Hi, it's Michael here. I have a question for you. What's in your Spotify playlist? One of my favorite songs was written and played by Dream Theater. It goes like this. Where do we come from? Why are we here? Where do we go when we die? While we have no idea how to answer the last two questions, we do know something about where we come from. The Big Bang. Scientists theorize that we all come from the same place, even if the term place is ambiguous in nature. We should say we all come from the same singularity. According to the Big Bang model, the matter in your body is billions of years old because nothing existed before it, and all that exists comes from it, even us. But what triggered the Big Bang? Follow me on this video to get to know more about the Big Bang model and the origin of the universe. First, saying that the Big Bang is a theory could be misleading. Because of the ones who are not used to a scientific language, the word theory recalls something a little far-fetched. Well, this isn't the case. The word theory in the scientific field does not have the same meaning as it has in the expression in theory. In science, the word theory means system of hypotheses capable of coherently explaining a large number of observations. Theories are taught because they represent the state of the art of our knowledge on a given set of phenomena. They are always open to improvement, but they are the best we have at the moment. If you hear someone saying, "It's just a theory, it doesn't mean anything," it would be like asking, "Why do we teach basketball since it's just a set of movements?" We teach it precisely because it is a set of movements to which we attribute a corporal, social, and cultural value. In fact, the Big Bang is the predominant theory and model in the scientific community based on astronomical evidence and observations. It is a cosmological model based on the idea that the universe began to expand at a very high speed in a finite time in the past, starting from a condition of extreme curvature, temperature, and density, and that this process continues to this day. According to most astrophysicists, all the matter found in the universe today, including the matter in people, plants, animals, the earth, stars, and galaxies, was created at the very first moment of time, thought to be about 13 billion years ago. The universe began, scientists believe, with every speck of its energy jammed into a very tiny point. Everything in the known universe was compressed into a dot smaller than an atom. This extremely dense point exploded with unimaginable force, creating matter and propelling it outward to make billions of galaxies in our vast universe. Astrophysicists dubbed this titanic explosion the Big Bang. The Big Bang was like no explosion you might witness on Earth today. For instance, a hydrogen bomb explosion whose center registers approximately 100 million degrees Celsius moves through the air at about 300 meters per second. In contrast, cosmologists believe the Big Bang flung energy in all directions at the speed of light, 300,000 meters per second, a million times faster than the H-bomb, and estimate that the temperature of the entire universe was 1,000 trillion degrees Celsius at just a tiny fraction of a second after the explosion. Even the cores of the hottest stars in today's universe are much cooler than that. So the Big Bang is the observed truth, but some details haven't been quite worked out. There are a lot of things that may have happened, and we need a different explanations to explain those. Or maybe we don't have an explanation at all. In fact, science isn't about being right all the time. It's about being wrong. If everything was perfectly known, science would lose its intrinsic meaning. There's another important quality of this Big Bang that makes it unique. While an explosion of a man-made bomb expands through the air, the Big Bang did not expand through anything. That's because there was no space to expand through at the beginning of time. This means that if I and you were sitting on the singularity when it happened, we would have been incinerated, but we wouldn't have heard any bang. But now the point is, every explosion has an ignition point and a center of the explosion. What about the Big Bang? Let's suppose you're on a date and you go out and look at the sky. Suddenly, he or she asks you to point to where the Big Bang happened. Well, my suggestion, in this case, would be to immediately leave, because there is no central point. There is nowhere in the sky you can point and say, "That's where the Big Bang was." Because the Big Bang was everything, and it happened on the moon, it happened on the sun, it happened in your bedroom, it happened everywhere. Also, at the Peach Epoch, the universe was only a tiny fraction of a second old. In fact, it was even tinier than a tiny fraction, 10 to the negative 36 seconds old, or thereabout. From there on out, we have a roughly decent picture of how the universe works. Some questions are still open, of course, but in general, we have at least a vague understanding. At even earlier times, though, our understanding of the universe gets fuzzy. The forces, energies, densities, and temperatures become too high, and the knowledge of physics we've cobbled together over the centuries just isn't up to the task. In the extreme early universe, gravity starts to get very important at small scales, and this is the realm of quantum gravity, the yet-to-be-solved grand riddle of modern physics. We just flat-out don't have an understanding of strong gravity at small scales. We just don't. Earlier than 10 to the negative 36 seconds, we simply don't understand the nature of the universe. The Big Bang Theory is fantastic at describing everything after that, but before it, we're a bit lost. Get this, at small enough scales, we don't even know if the word before even makes sense. At incredibly tiny scales, and I'm talking tinier than the tiniest thing you could possibly imagine, the quantum nature of reality rears its ugly head at full strength, rending our neat, orderly, friendly space-time into a broken jungle gym of loops and tangles and rusty spikes. Notions of intervals in time or space don't really apply at those scales. Who knows what's going on? The only thing we can do is to try to make suppositions. For example, in a new paper that appeared in November 2019, researchers detailed the mechanisms that could cause the explosion, which is key for the models that scientists use to understand the origin of the universe. In particular, they define the critical criteria where we can drive a flame to self-generate its own turbulence, spontaneously accelerate, and transition into detonation. Actually, they were exploring the supersonic reactions for propulsion, and as a result of that, they came across this mechanism. The key is applying the right amount of turbulence and mixing to an unconfined flame until it becomes self-perpetuating, at which point the flame begins to burn the ingested energy, leading to a hypersonic supernova explosion. There are, of course, some other ideas out there, models that attempt to describe what ignited the Big Bang, but at this stage, they're pure speculation. If these ideas can provide observational clues, then hooray, we can do science. But what kind of observations lead to the Big Bang model? During the 1920s and 30s, Edwin Hubble discovered that the universe is expanding, with galaxies moving away from each other at a velocity given by an expression known as Hubble's law, where V equals H times R. Here, V represents the galaxy's recessional velocity, R is its distance away from Earth, and H is a constant of proportionality called Hubble's constant. The exact value of the Hubble constant is somewhat uncertain, but is generally believed to be around 70 kilometers per second. For every megaparsec in distance, kilometers per second per megaparsec. A megaparsec is given by 1 MPC is equal to 3 times 10 to the 6 light years. This means that a galaxy 1 megaparsec away will be moving away from us at a speed of about 70 kilometers per second, while another galaxy 100 megaparsecs away will be receding at 100 times this speed. So essentially, the Hubble constant sets the rate at which the universe is expanding. Since the universe is expanding, we can intuitively observe that. At a certain point in the past, everything must have been squeezed into a tiny volume. If we manipulate the Hubble's law, we can see that the age of the universe can be assessed vis-a-vis the Hubble constant. The inverse of the Hubble constant has units of time. By substituting in kilometers for megaparsecs in the Hubble constant, we find that upon inverting h, we get a quantity with units of seconds, kilometers canceling out in the denominator and numerator. For a Hubble constant of 100 kilometers per second per megaparsec, we get 3 times 10 to the 17 seconds, or about 10 billion years. This is how we determine the age of the universe, more or less. This is pretty much what we do know about the Big Bang model and what caused the Big Bang. Anyway, trying to explain the birth of our universe is all but simple. But we have to thank our curiosity for that, with a healthy dose of optimism that it can lead us to a deeper understanding of the mechanisms that underlie the birth of the universe. we would like to end this video with a piece of the lyrics from The Spirit Carries On, the song we recalled in the intro. I may never find all the answers. I may never understand why. I may never prove what I know to be true, but I know that I still have to try. This video ends here, sending love from our team. Are you a fan of the Big Bang model? Do you think we will ever find out what really caused the Big Bang? Drop a line below and let us know what you think.